Becoming an American is a very significant moment in my life. It not only redefines who I am, it actually gives me the sense of freedom and ability to sort of forget the boundaries and like forget the sense of oppression that always followed from the moment that since I remember myself. I first came here, it's ironic that I first came here in 1998, summer, as an exchange student. Then exactly 10 years later, summer of 2008, I came here for good. And then exactly 10 years later, summer of 2018, I'm officially an American. So it's interesting how like the timeline worked out that way, but yeah. Sometimes, I mean, my friends used to joke all the time that, you know, I was an American, you know, before I even discovered America, so. I literally counted up to 100 people to call me an artist before I actually said or tweeted or wrote that I'm an artist or call myself an artist. I had a sketchbook with me and I started drawing, and one of the first drawings that I did in my line, you know, in my style as a line work and with a pen that felt really comfortable and really me, and I realized, oh my god, this is it. The first drawing was the act. And I see art as life because it starts from nothing and it turns into everything and anything. There is a system. In my head, the way it registers is that there is a system that I follow. That as if I have discovered or created some sort of a code that I know where, you know, but it's not like limited. It's not something that, oh, it's not the set of rules that I follow. It's the set of directions that I can go towards. And these directions are not set in concrete. They move, they're very flexible. So these directions give me the flexibility to change the perspective the way I want. Let's say if this was a language, I have defined the words, I have defined the sentences, but I can reshuffle the words and the sentences and make anything and everything out of it. And the reason why I'm drawn to this very simple line art that creates these really complex systems is that it's the game between the nothing and everything. I believe all good art comes from a dark place. There are events and things that happen that put us in the position that every single person on this planet at some point in time has been an underdog. I was an underdog. I was not welcome, I was not good enough. So for years, this subject was bothering me. So I wanted to, I mean, one day I just grabbed the Sharpie and painted the first piece that's hanging on the wall there. I just called it Underdog One. Because if you don't face the wound, you're not going to be able to heal it. And how we deal with our struggle is what my Underdog series is designed to depict. I don't like to bring politics into what I draw or what I paint directly, but I bring politics into my life. Especially when you are being affiliated with different brands or corporations, as an artist, people will brand you and label you as if, oh, this guy's a sellout and he's not a manufacturer, and I'm not a salesperson. I'm a creator, and I want to be able to be creating 20 or 30 years as freely, as openly as I am right now.